Right, so as I do this, I want to make sure whoever, whatever's watching this, don't you dare get any fucking false pretense that you and I are on some similar team. You've made that very apparent. I got this thing here. I'm going to look it up with you. What is the D C C C? I'm not fucking kidding. At 4:30 South Capitol Street, SE. What is this? DCCC.org. Now, I'm really hoping somebody isn't trying to deliver on an old murder hedge. Who are these people? We want to hear from you. It says something about electioning, but it doesn't say who they are. I think they might just be terrorists. I think that's all they are. I think they're just terrorists, and that they're probably capitalizing on what happened in early 2018. Does anybody remember? Jobs page. I see 16 of 16 job opportunities. I see. Okay, this is basically just an act of terrorism by mail. And the question is, why are they allowed to do this? Is this go to Seth? What was his name? I don't know his last name. His last name has changed in the public record a couple of times. Seth was murdered. It wasn't just some random senseless crime. Seth was strategically murdered because of a variety of reasons, but primarily, I believe, because somebody was attempting to do something they were not supposed to do from within the campaign. And when that happened, he got identified as somebody that would have been considered a field commander. It was a military or paramilitary sort of strike. And the understanding is that it was to be the first, it was to be a manner in which to confirm certain facts, and then after that, it was supposed to allow for an identification of those that were involved in the criminal conspiracy. Now, I think what happened was the civilian leadership in that regard got caught, and she attempted some evasive maneuvers, and for the last 3 years, it has strategically destroyed anything about the civil society in the United States in order to lay the foundation for a bioterror campaign that I believe she had every intention of being involved in one manner or another. And by virtue of not being elected to the presidency herself, had engaged in various kinds of maneuvers with the understanding that from another position she would be able to accomplish her goals. And in the meantime, there is very significant questions as to whether the alleged opposition political candidate is actually opposition, or is rather an infiltrator alleging to represent the opposition party viewpoint, with an understanding that he has considerable leverage over the party due to acts of blackmail that have already been acquired and that have not been provided with any counter leverage in the form of successful exposure of the manner in which the blackmail contributes to the criminal conspiracy, or with any counter leverage in the form of somebody from within the party or within the actual government structure that isn't similarly compromised, that the corruption's that pervasive. On Christmas Eve of 2017, No, Christmas Eve of 2019, 2018 into 2019, Nikki Haley was in Israel. It was after Donald Trump. I believe it was December 14th, because Donald Trump was in Iraq. No, the Christmas Eve, December 24th, Donald Trump was in Iraq because he blew a nuclear hedge. And he had to go on site to Iraq as part of disgusting toxic wave off. And I saw it. And I saw the setup and all the different things that went into it. And, you know, the best part was that the state of Texas at that time was basically launching the attack, and they missed the mark in some ways. But in other ways, it doesn't really seem to matter if political operators in the state of Texas missed the mark. Because for whatever reason, they've got a very substantial share in the leverage that gets wielded with this blackmail. It's been a way that way for a while. You know, that's why you have to keep sending people down here on site for major economic events that, even if they're pre-announced, end up having some sort of additional emergency component associated with them, because they usually correlate with time frames where Texas has been more and more consistently blowing it because it's that comprehensive and profoundly unsustainable. And so he had to go to Iraq, and the political leadership of Iraq was very dissatisfied. And I'm pretty sure it's because they saw what I just saw. I'm pretty sure that's what they saw. And you know, the question becomes one of, well, if you ram into the unconscious an association with a predilection for preferencing minor girls that fit a demographic profile that's not from your community, what are you supposed to say when the president appears with his wife in your country at a military installation while that's streaming all over the damn country? That's exactly what was happening. And meanwhile, around that time, Nikki Haley was at a public appearance discussing the legacy of the great nation of Israel, and also discussing something about some of the not so nice aspects. And there was a picture of her at a podium with a variety of Israeli elders behind her, as if she was the submarine and they were her battery. And I said, this is going to come up later. You got fucking Kamala fucking Harris coming to fucking Fort Worth. Is she supposed to confirm and accede to the stock split? Which stocks are you going to fucking offer? Are you offering the black stock or the Indian stock? Is that what we have to look forward to in the next fucking 4 years of Kamala Harris as vice president? That she's just going to be deployed by that disgusting, perverted old boy to go make some stock transfers on site for him and his disgusting, perverted old boys? I have a feeling it is. See, he let his son get knocked off, who was the attorney general, so he could presumably get to be the president. He doesn't have the political capital himself anymore, does he? So he gets a biracial former attorney general woman to go do those deals for him, because his son wouldn't fucking do it. His son wouldn't have done it, and that's why they murdered him, and you made me watch it in front of my fucking students, and every fucking day since then, you've denied that that's exactly what fucking happened. Do you understand? What the fuck is the rest of the fucking world? What the fuck is every young woman in this country, especially, by the way, if she happens to be biracial, supposed to fucking think about this? You're gonna pretend it's something else. You're gonna pretend it's, I saw what the fuck you're working, Kamala.